evening. I'd like to call a regular meeting of the Board of Trustees of January 27, 2015 to order. Please join the board and myself to the Pledge of Allegiance to the flag of the United States of America. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all. Clerk Bruce, would you kindly call the roll?
Trustee Adler?
Here.
Trustee Barr?
Here.
Trustee Manzo?
Here.
Trustee Moy?
Here.
Trustee Woolen?
Here.
Trustee Youssef?
Here.
And President LaMalani?
Here. Thank you. Opening comments. First of all, this past Thursday, the Oak Brook Chamber of Commerce held their first Economic Development Partnership Council meeting at the Inland Real Estate. The council is made up of Oak Brook business owners, brokers, hotel managers, and members of our village staff. The main purpose of the council meeting is to retain and attract businesses for Oak Brook, increase commerce, and attract and maintain a talented workforce.
I start with the opening comments again. This past Thursday, the Oak Brook Chamber of Commerce held the first Economic Development Partnership Council meeting of 2015 at the Inland Real Estate.
The council is composed of mainly Oak Brook business owners, brokers, hotel managers, and members of our village staff. The main purpose of the council is to retain and attract businesses for Oak Brook, increase commerce, and attract and maintain a talented workforce. Additionally, the council works with our village to improve transportation infrastructure so that we are able to support the initiatives that strengthen a positive business climate in Oak Brook. At the meeting, on your behalf, I spoke about the strong relationship we share with both the retail and commercial partners, which allows our homeowners to have a significantly smaller property tax burden compared to the other communities. Our residents realize that by sharing the tax base with so many of these commercial property owners, they pay much less in taxes than the homeowners in the surrounding communities. The village of Oak Brook understands that the success of every commercial enterprise in Oak Brook is critical to the village's economic sustainability. It's no accident that in 2014, the village of Oak Brook generated the best year in sales tax revenues due to a very robust commercial activity in Oak Brook. I also, at this moment, actually like to thank Trustee Barr, who serves on this committee along with me, as well as Bob Colleen and Rick Genex, who serve on this committee, have done a tremendous job over the last several years. Trustee Woolen, I like to thank him because he participates in substituting for one of us when either Barr or I are not there. And I want to thank Trustee Woolen for attending the meeting last Thursday. Additionally, Jeff Kennedy, who is the chairman of the Commercial Revitalization and Streetscape Committee, gave a nice presentation on the proposed new signage and the infrastructure needs that the committee is focusing on. His presentation was well received, and I'd like to thank everybody who participated on that day at this council meeting. I'm convinced that our relationship with the chamber has been the strongest it has been in many, many years. And I'm so thankful to each one of you for participating in the economic development program of our village. In addition to these activities at the council meeting on Thursday last week, we also had Patty Bellock there, who is a guest speaker at the economic development council meeting on Thursday last week. She certainly gave us a lot of insight as to what are the new changes that are going to be coming in Springfield, and talked about the $7 billion budget deficit that nobody likes to think about, but it's going to happen. And what is it that the governor, honor, and staff might have to do to deal with the $7 billion budget deficit coming up. Secondly and lastly, I'd like to mention that in the January issue of the West Suburban Magazine, there's a featured article about the village of Oak Brook. It's an excellent article that focuses on our history and how the village has evolved into a major hub for businesses, retail development, and destination location with our hotels and fine dining establishments. It also highlights the wonderful amenities that we have here in our sports court and the park district for our residents as well as the visitors to enjoy. I encourage you to either pick up the magazine or go to the library. I believe we have that magazine there or go to West Suburban Living website to read this article, a really nicely written article on Oak Brook. That concludes my report. Are there any visitor comments, Charlotte?
None tonight.
Okay, thank you. Next, we move on to the agenda number 5, approval of the minutes. May I have a motion for the approval of the minutes from the executive meeting of December
9,
2014?
So moved.
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say yes.
Yes.
Any objections? Motion carries. Next, I have a motion. May I have a motion for the approval of the minutes from the meeting of January 13, 2015?
You know, they've done the work.
Second?
Second.
Any discussion?
They've done the work so they can...
All those in favor say yes?
Yes.
Any objection? Motion carries. I will now kindly request that you direct your attention to the screen where the consent agenda is available for your viewing. Does any board member wish to have any item removed from the consent agenda? Yes, Trustee Adler.
Item E.
Okay.
Item E says nothing.
Any other items? Seeing none, may I have a motion to approve the consent agenda with the exception of the extracted item E?
So moved.
Second.
And authorize the expenditures? Second?
Second.
Clerk Bruce, may I have a roll call vote, please?
Trustee Adler?
Yes.
Trustee Barr is not here. Trustee Manzo?
Yes.
Trustee Moy?
Yes.
Trustee Willen?
Yes.
Trustee Youssef?
Yes.
Okay, motion carries. Trustee Adler, you want to discuss item E?
Thank you. Yes, I do. Move to discuss.
Don't need a motion.
Mr. President.
Motion?
There's no items under E.
It's a question of whether there should be an item.
There's no...
On this agenda, though, there's no item.
It says none at this time.
Right. I mean, two things. First, you don't need a motion to discuss. Second, there's no action that can be taken because there's nothing on the agenda, only discussion.
Okay.
Okay.
So we're discussing an item that none at this time.
I don't know what it is.
We are discussing an item that does not exist. Yeah.
Okay.
Okay. Yeah. All right. Go ahead, Trustee Adler.
Fine. My concerns here relate to... going back about a week and a half, there was an announcement of and a press release of promotions. These had been reviewed with the board. I don't take exception to the promotions. My point is that I believe that these constitute budget adjustments. We are creating 4 new positions, which are unique and different positions from those which previously existed. The 3 individuals who were promoted to new positions. By my way of thinking, I would believe that that falls under the provisions for a budget adjustment under the Village Code. And also, putting aside the technicalities, I've been contacted by a resident asking me about the new position that's being added. And when discussion was had about this, the explanation was that that new position, for which we'll have to go out and make an outside hire, would come back to the board. We're already recruiting for that position. I got a communication from a resident asking what's up. I can't tell him what's up. Nor for that matter can I explain the adjustments that are being made, what new responsibilities are being given to these employees. So I believe they constitute budget adjustments when you are creating new positions, unique and different from the positions formerly held by the current employees, which should be approved by the board as to their salary grade, as to the compensation range on the position, and also approving the compensation adjustments. That hasn't happened. I think it's an Open Meetings Act matter. In terms of the board taking that action to approve these adjustments, so that is my concern.
For discussion only, as mentioned a few minutes ago, this is not an action item. Rick, did you want to respond?
Yes, Trustee Adler and I have had a discussion about this, and as I said during the our executive session 2 weeks ago, I came forward and informed the board my intentions to operate under my authority. I had that discussion, the same discussion again with Trustee Adler on Friday afternoon, and I did speak to our village attorney and discuss this. And while our code of ordinance states what an acting, an interim, temporary manager or person exercising such duties cannot do, it means that the village manager can do them.
I would just say that's an inference.
Excuse me.
Let him finish. Yeah.
In the memo distributed to the board back in May 7th of 2013, it clearly speaks about the roles of the president, board members, statutory boards, standing committees, and the village manager and the village attorney. And it clearly states that the village manager has the chief administrative responsibilities over the village affairs, including the hiring and firing of village employees. Plus, as we are saving budgeted dollars with these personnel changes, there's no budget amendment that's going to be needed to bring forward to the board for approval, as we're not going over the budget. And finally, our position classification, salary plan, and salary adjustment administration policy clearly gives the village manager the authority to do so, specifically when it comes to promotions.
I would just point out that your authority to hire is to hire employees that have been approved by the board. It's not a unilateral authority to go out and hire anybody and anyone you want at any salary that you want, to be clear. So that reference to your authority, it doesn't trump the village code provisions with respect to budget amendments, which are clear. You haven't been granted authority from the board to make the budget adjustments, and that's what would be necessary under the village code and also under the state code. I'm not buying. But more importantly, you know, you've been on the job 3 months. In terms of building your relationship with this board and with this community, I would urge you to err on the side of over-disclosing and explaining yourself as opposed to informing people that you have authority.
I think I went far beyond coming forward and advising this board in an executive session my intentions in gathering consensus. I've been nothing but open and honest with this board on my intentions. And I find it odd that during the interview process, the publication that was put out by the search firm talked about wanting a macro manager. And what I'm finding is a lot of micromanagement.
Well, I would tell you that given my fairly significant experience in management, you earn respect. It's almost been my experience that you build your respect. You build your relationship with people, with this board, etc. So I wouldn't get too hung up on words, but your explanation, if you ask me what's changed about these individuals' responsibilities, and in some cases you've granted significant salary adjustments, I can't answer that question. And I can't answer that question to residents that want to know.
Well,
explain. What you explained to us was that there was going to be discussion. You never told, when we met about this, you never told us that you were going to be issuing a press release.
I disagree. I vehemently disagree.
I would like to hear other thoughts from other trustees. Trustee Youssef? Yeah.
These changes that were made, which I believe we did discuss in executive session, which I believe there was a consensus reached, and which I believe I did ask, now, are we authorizing this?
Correct.
And the general consensus of the majority was yes. Will any of these changes result in the need for budget adjustments at some point through this year? Or is the money we have budgeted in those departments and those categories adequate to meet the expenditures?
They are.
Yeah.
Correct. They are.
Then there's no budget adjustment, and there's nothing to discuss under the scope of this non-existent or existent agenda item, depending on how you classify it. If there's no, if none of these actions will precipitate a budget adjustment in this year, there is no budget adjustment. And that's, in my opinion, a non-issue.
Okay. Yeah. Trustee Wallen?
Yeah, I agree with Trustee Youssef. I think it's a non-issue. I think it was entirely legitimate to discuss the promotions in a closed session. It's a personnel issue. There could have been serious disagreements, complaints about various people, and I think it was appropriate to discuss it, and I believe that the village manager has the authority to do what he did. So I think it's a non-issue.
Trustee Mansell?
Well, I'm assuming we checked with counsel, Peter. Is he within the scope of his authority to do this?
Yeah, I don't think, I do not think it's a budget amendment. If you look at the village code, talks about changing or creating subclasses within an object class or object classes themselves. We're not doing that. None of the numbers in the budget change. The two positions, assistant village manager and finance director, already existed. So I agree with the village manager. I don't think it is a budget amendment, and I don't think it required village board approval, which was why there was nothing improper about discussing it in executive session, and there was no final action taken in executive session because no final action was needed.
Trustee Moy?
Yeah, well, just help me understand where your objections done. It sounds like you're saying that because there were promotions and the creation of a new position, let's say, assistant manager, the finance director, that we, the board, should have in open session okayed that move and not just have it come from the office of the village manager? Is that what your
Correct.
Objection?
Okay. Correct. Right. It's, those are unique positions. There is a new position. We have not approved a new position. This is no different than going through a budget process. And when we add positions to this village staff, we discuss those village, those additional positions in a budgeting process. This is no different. The village code reads clear to me, and what's being proffered to is not a reference to the village code or the state law, but rather what's said in the salary survey about making adjustments within grades. And that's, I understand that, but this is much different. These are new positions. These are unique positions. You wouldn't come in a budget process and not offer a graded position that's been run through human resources to come up with what the salary grade is, to tell you what the salary range is if you were going to add new positions. This is no different.
Okay, sounds like it's an different interpretations of the same codes. And I would have to go with our legal counsel, who says it's within the authority of the village manager to make these moves. So I understand your concern, but if Peter says it's legal and within Rick's authority to do this, I have to side with our legal counsel on that point. The other point about being transparent about this is that I knew about this before the closed session. When I go to talk to Rick, he mentioned it to me. I said, it sounds reasonable. We discussed it in closed session with the whole board there, and the consensus was reached that it sounds reasonable. And as far as budget adjustments, I understand it actually saves the village $53,000 by making these moves in salaries. So certainly there's no increase in the budget, so I don't see a problem with the budget adjustment concern, because the moves actually save the village money. I think it comes down to you just feel that we need, as a board, to okay this move. It sounds like from our legal counsel that we really don't. So I would have to side with legal counsel at this point until something else comes up.
Thank you.
Let me ask you, how about if you were going $1 million one way and
$1 million the other way, and he netted to a zero.
Excuse me, I have not given you the floor, Trustee Adler. You need to have the chair lead the discussion.
I thought we were having a discussion.
Trustee Youssef?
Yeah, as long as this has been done, and as long as there's a press release out there, I think it would be prudent in the interest of transparency for the purposes of everybody sitting here and everybody watching on TV or on their computer, that we provide a short explanation of the changes we've made. I don't feel that they in any way require board action. I don't feel that they'll necessarily, it's not like we're moving money from this department to that department. My understanding, based on the question I ask, is there's money in each budget area to cover these expenditures, and a transfer will not be required. Some of the position adjustments were fairly small in nature. And again, it did result in net savings, but I think it'd be wonderful if either, you know, probably our village manager could take a couple of minutes and explain exactly what was done for the purposes of the public.
Sure.
Actions that I fully support, by the way.
Thank you. We had in the budget, I don't have the figures with me, approximately 170 some thousand for an assistant village manager's position with salary and benefits. Coming here and looking at the structure of the organization and seeing where we were lacking as a backup or a succession plan was in the area of finance. The village had an assistant finance director when Sharon was that. When one of our director left, our finance director left, Sharon was easily able to walk into that position without losing any step for the village. We don't have that now. And looking at the organization, I decided to combine the assistant village manager role, which was budgeted, with the finance director. And as I told the board, to use the funding that was there to bring on an assistant finance director at a much, much lower cost savings. That was the one position. And the other one was the second position. The third position was promotion of Jim Fox from assistant director of IT to director of IT. Jim has done an excellent job and he deserves that. The fourth position was giving one of our administrative staff the duties of deputy clerk, because she's doing that right now and she's been doing it for some time, and that was a small 3% increase. But that's basically the entire four moves in a nutshell, and we're looking to save anywhere from $53,000 with these moves. And if the individual we hire comes in and doesn't take our insurance, we could be saving well over $70,000.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And just to make it clear, we had a temporary contract employee fulfilling the duties of assistant village manager. So it wasn't like the position was vacant and there was nobody filling it. That individual's term of contract is winding down.
This Friday, yes.
That's right.
So we moved our finance director into a double role. And now instead of her as finance director being paid under finance director, there's going to be an assistant hired at a lower salary. Her salary is assistant village manager, even though she'll be fulfilling both duties, and please correct me if I'm wrong, is within the amount budgeted for that position.
Well within the amount, yes.
Thank you.
I believe this is a non-issue and it's not on the agenda, but I'll give you the courtesy of making some closing remarks on this issue.
Could you explain what assistant village manager responsibilities are being transferred to Sharon? Because that wasn't discussed when we met on this.
We did put together a job description. I'd be happy to share it tomorrow.
Well, you can just talk through.
That's Michael Manage.
You send it to him?
This is for the benefit of our residents, those here and watching.
And I think we talked about it that evening being an evolutionary process. There are some things that Sharon's going to be involved with. Our IRMA representative, who Kathy Dolazinski is that now. Sharon is starting to become involved in the labor negotiation process. She's been in one or two meetings with us now. So as those roles come up, those things will be moved on to her.
I believe that the majority of the board is comfortable as well as very proud of the promotions that you've made, and they're well deserved, and in some cases actually long overdue. We need to move on. Certainly this is not an agenda item or an action item. Number 8, Costco. Trustee Moy, would you present the Costco variation and make the appropriate motion?
Thank you, President Lamalani. Let me get this on my screen. I move to concur with the recommendation from the Zoning Board of Appeals to approve the requested variation to the rear yard setback for the property located at 1901 22nd Street, subject to the following conditions. 1, front yard. Reduce the existing 38-foot front yard setback to 32 feet as measured to the eave for an approximate length of 36 feet 4 inches. This will allow the new vestibule structure to be accommodated within the encroachment area. 2, the proposed development shall be constructed in substantial conformance to the approved plans as revised. 3, all the provisions of Ordinance 98-ZO-V-S-900 will remain in effect. 4, add the condition, quote, notwithstanding the attached exhibits, the applicant shall meet all village ordinance requirements at the time of building permit application, except as specifically varied or waived, end quote. And 5, adoption of an ordinance necessary to grant the requested variation,
February 10th, 2015.
Which ordinance the village attorney shall, by this motion, be directed to prepare for consideration at the February 10th, 2015 Board of Trustees meeting. Second. Basically, this is a request by Costco to put in an entrance vestibule to an entrance that already exists, but because the vestibule will kind of encroach a little bit more into the setback, they're asking for the variance. And Bob, you want to explain it?
Again, it's on this picture here, there is the current door is there. Because they're converting some indoor parking to office space, they need to make this a more formal entrance and exit, and that's what they're doing. And again, it appears to be very reasonable with the amount of vegetation you have on 22nd Street, and for the small distance of the encroachment, it's really it will be very non-noticeable to the public.
Right, so the zoning committee voted unanimously to approve this request, and I stand for it also.
Okay. Any discussion?
Yes.
Trustee.
I'm in favor of this. I don't see another viable way to achieve this that wouldn't place an excessive burden on them. The whole building's about 400 feet in length, and we're talking about a small fraction of it. And as long as we're on the subject of Costco variances, I would love to see them come in and ask for a variance so they can put another sign up with the price of their gasoline, because it blows everybody else out of the water. It's 15 to 20 cents cheaper than everybody. And I think that message needs to get out there for their sake, as well as for the sake of our residents and people passing through who will have a money-saving opportunity.
Yeah, it went down to $1.78, I think it was, last week. Yeah.
I filled up at $1.84, and I thought that was good. When the vote comes up, I will not be recusing myself, but in the interest of transparency, I did check with our village attorney. I do own a small amount of Costco stock. I've gotten the legal opinion that recusal is not necessary. It's a small part of my holdings, and it's certainly, this project is a small part of Costco's holdings. So I just wanted to explain that to everybody before the vote came up, so nobody's caught off guard.
Any further discussion?
Roll call.
Don't go with, yeah.
Trustee Manzo.
Yes.
Trustee Moy.
Yes.
Trustee Willen.
Yes.
Trustee Youssef.
Yes.
Trustee Adler.
Yes.
That passes.
Motion carries. Thank you for coming, and I also want to take a moment to thank Chuck, who has been a very strong component and strong supporter of the chamber activities. I neglected to mention his name earlier. And thank you for the dynamic work that you do in the Oak Brook Center and supporting us in every way. Chuck, thank you for coming. Did you want to say a few words?
I just had a question.
You need to come to the mic, yeah.
This is kind of an important question.
Yeah.
All questions are important.
Did you vote on the consent agenda?
Yes.
Oh, you did. Okay. Because I heard that you took the one item off, and then I don't think there was a vote, was there?
Yeah, prior to that. Prior to
okay,
that,
right. I just want to make sure. Yeah, it's very important to us.
We're right on track.
Right.
Well, I appreciate it. This has been as I said, the process was really wonderful. The shopping center and the community, I think, are going to benefit from what we're doing. And I appreciate the vote of confidence. We're looking forward to another good year. We had a great year this year, as I've indicated, and what you've seen in sales. The community is responding very well to some of the recent improvements, and we're just thrilled about being able to take to the next step. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you for the good work that you always do. Thanks. You're welcome to stay, Chuck. Next item on the agenda is number
10,
I believe, confirmation of appointments on the Oak Brook Hotel Convention and Visitors Committee. As you all know, this committee consists of 9 members whose terms expire every end of February, every year. And the committee consists of 5 people who operate or manage a hotel or motel within the corporate limits of the village, 1 representative of the Oak Brook Center, and 1 representative from the chamber, and 2 residents at large of the village. Today, I would like to submit to you for approval the appointments of Tracy McQueen and Simon Fricker, who is a new appointee because he's the general manager of the Le Meridian, which is a new entrance to the hotel here. These are the 2 new appointments that I would like to recommend for approval. And the reappointment of the 2 residents that we have, Dr. Abbasi from Forest Glen and Mort Coughlin from Fullersburg Subdivision, to the Oak Brook Hotel Convention and Visitors Committee. So these are the approvals that I'm seeking from you, the appointments of these 2 individuals, Tracy McQueen and Simon Fricker from the Le Meridian, and the reappointments of Dr. Abbasi and Mort Coughlin.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
Any discussion? All those in favor say yes?
Yes.
Yes. Yes.
Any objection? Motion carries. Thank you. Information and update. Rick, do you have any further update?
No, I just do want to thank and congratulate Sharon on her new position and Jim on his new position, and I would hope you all join me in doing that. They'll assume their new roles Sunday, the 1st. And last but not least, I know Kathy Dolakowski's not here tonight, but I do want to thank her for all her work and all the time she's been with us this last year. She's going to end her contract relationship with us this Friday. She served as the interim assistant village manager and has really done a great job. I think she came to the organization under a difficult transition period and had to fill a very large role and did so very, very well with incredible professionalism. And I can't thank her enough for all the help she gave me when I came here. And that's difficult for a person who's a contract employee, even though that they know that their time is coming to an end. So. I would, again, just if you see her, just tell her thank you, and we'll miss her. That's all.
The board and I echo your sentiments as well. I think she was a tremendous person who came in at the right time during the transition and helped us out. Yeah, we appreciate that. Clerk Prust, do you have any updates to impart?
I do. I have 2 items. First of all, to remind everybody that we do voter registration here at the Village Hall and at the library, and that it ends March 10th. Then you have to go to early voting or out to the county. So please come in and we're available. Also, we sent out the Winter Quarterly magazine to everybody, and inside, we provided an application for an absentee ballot to be sent to the county. The instructions are on one side, and we even typed in the consolidated April 7th election. So all you have to do is sign it and send it in with your signature and where you want it sent. And let me tell you, you can Xerox this. But if you need further copies, of course, call me, because that's what I'm here for, to help you out. I expect everybody to vote. The second thing I want to discuss is live streaming. And we've just started this, which means if you get home late from work or for some reason are tired and don't want to come to the board meeting, you can also watch it live. And if you go on the website, on the center where it says government and then by the village board, at the left-hand side, you notice it says live board meeting. And please just click on that and you get to see the board meeting with all of us sitting here with all the discussion and learn what's going on ASAP. And if you have questions, please let me know. We've been working with this since late fall, and we've got all the bugs worked out. And you know, of course, my goal always is to communicate and have everybody see the board meetings as they go. I still have the videotapes there, but I've had positive responses from people who are watching it. And if you have further questions, just call me, because, you know, that's what I'm here for. And that's my information for tonight. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Charlotte. Peter, do you have any updates?
Nothing to report tonight.
Oh, thank you.
I always try.
Yes.
Okay. Now we go to the staff.
I think I will.
I saw our fire chief.
I hope so.
You're the main man.
Better, I'll tell your wife.
No? Bess? Sue?
Sorry, I didn't think I was going to go so quickly. I would just like to thank Dr. Moy, who is going to be making an appearance at the library on Sunday, February 8th at 2 o'clock. He's going to talk once again about medical marijuana. He did speak on this same issue a few months back, did a terrific job, and we had a marvelous discussion afterwards. So if you are interested, I do invite you to come. Thank you.
I'm looking forward to this new challenge of my new position, and I just want to thank Rick and the Village Board for their support and trust in me. Thank you.
Thank you. Mike?
We have not had a lot of volume of snow, but we've had a lot of hovering around the freezing point, which presents other challenges. In some ways, it's more dangerous driving and walking especially, so everyone should be careful. We are applying de-icing agents to try and keep everything as safe as possible, but be careful out there. Our crews are not bored. We're actually having a chance to do a lot of forestry issues and other general street maintenance. So this is kind of a boon to us. But winter's not over. Watch the ice, especially even if there's not a lot of snow around. Thanks a lot.
Bob?
Just as a precursor for 2 weeks from now, the Duchess Waugh development project will come before you for approval. The part that they need approval on is the consolidation of the two subdivision lots. But what will be exciting is they're going to bring a presentation that evening, about a 5-minute presentation beyond computer, that will show you what the building will look like, how it will impact the neighbors, etc. They did share that with the Plan Commission, that discussion, and at this point, it appears that they've worked out all the issues with the neighbors. It's going to be a 5-story building, 225,000 square feet. It probably will be our nicest building.
So. Thank you. I believe it, we are done. Yeah. Thank you to the board for cooperation today, and we're short and sweet. May I now have a motion to adjourn the regular meeting of the January 27, 2015 at 7:40?
Yeah.
So moved.
Second?
Second.
All those in favor say yes?
Yes.
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 Objection? Motion carries. Thank you.